What's going on? Adrian here with Green Building Network, and today we're on site with one of the worst mini split installations we've ever seen. It's 100 degrees on the third floor, and we're gonna get into why this mini split installation is so bad.
And I'm just gonna feel around with my finger, and if you can see that right there, all the fittings and all the hoses and all the lines are just oily. And what that tells us is there's a pretty massive refrigeration leak in here.
Now, one of the reasons this insulation is so bad is you can see it's pretty low on the wall here. There's a lot of weird architectural elements that had to be considered when choosing this model, but they chose the wrong model for the type of room that it is. There's another type of unit besides the high wall system called a floor mounted unit, which looks more like a radiator, which would have been more appropriate for this type of room to make sure it stays at the levels it wanted to be. Now, if placement of the mini split head was the only thing that was wrong with this system, it may have been fine for a while, but that's only the beginning. Check out to see what else we got going on with this thing.
So other than the fact that this mini split is not mounted high up on the wall, like this high wall cassette is supposed to be, it's really, first of all, it's poorly mounted. It's shaky, it's not mechanically attached properly. And the biggest pet peeve, this doesn't affect the performance, but we can't access the serial numbers without taking the whole unit off. So if we want to try to save the outside condenser, we can't do that because we can't get the model number to find any sort of compatibility. And big shock, the company that did this install, no longer in business. So these mini splits, they pull air from the top, that's their return, and they pass it through the coils and blow it out here and directionalize it with this automated fin. That can't work properly because it's too low, like Adrian was saying. But one of the most egregious things about this install, they just cut the wall sheathing back to make it fit, and the return is actually inside the wall cavity, so it's pulling dust. If this thing was running for more than a week, which it wasn't because it broke down, surprise, surprise, this would be filthy, full of all that gunk and dust and debris and old plaster dust from behind the walls.
You just keep looking and you keep pulling on that thread and you find more and more that's wrong with something like this. Thankfully, we have this large gap underneath the mini split system here. Why don't you come on in here and we can show these guys what we're looking at and what's so egregious about this. There's actually a refrigerant line in here that's completely unsheathed, meaning it's bringing in cold refrigeration to the unit, and there's nothing around it to insulate or keep condensation off of that. That alone in these hot, especially humid months, will bring tons of condensation onto the line, dripping down behind the wall and causing all kinds of issues with leaking and water getting behind there, mold, and just bad conditions all the way around. So we've only gotten a couple inches into this thing and already we're finding nothing but messes. If you can't see, I'm sweating bullets right now. If only there was some way we could find relief.
Can we please turn this thing on?
So one of life's unfortunate realities, AC systems don't break in the winter time, and it is hot as f up here. Adrian just pointed out we have uninsulated refrigerant lines that are leading to major condensation issues. Check this out. We have our refrigerant lines here, and I'm just gonna feel around with my finger. And if you can see that right there, all the fittings and all the hoses and all the lines are just oily. And what that tells us is there's a pretty massive refrigeration leak in here, which is gonna cause a really low charge, which is gonna cause this thing to ice up, which is gonna cause this thing to leak water and not cool effectively. And it's an indication, another indication, that this thing was really, really poorly installed. They didn't do any nitrogen tests, they didn't do any leak tests, and they left, they got their check, dissolved their LLC, and God knows how many people they did this to. Let's go take a look at where the line set enters the house. So there's really a lack of detail in the flashing here. The boot is underlapped properly, but there's no silicone, there's no caulking, there's no roofing cement to detail the edges. The fasteners are already starting to rust out. And what's most concerning is the insulation of the line set. It's a 6-month-old system and it's already degrading to the point where you can see bare copper. Ideally, this would be an either rigid channel that's UV resistant or a flexible sleeve that gets installed at the time of the line set insulation. Neither of these things happened, and the insulation is almost entirely trashed. That's gonna really cut down on the efficiency and longevity of this system right here.
So as you can see, what Sasha was just talking about over there, you'll see in the background of that video that their unit is actually mounted on the neighbor's wall. Now, it would be a party wall if it was inside of this house, but it's not. It's on their wall. That's gonna be causing vibrations. That's their property, and it's also on a very steep roof. So anyone that comes out to service this is going to need to have extra PPE. They're gonna have to be harnessed in. There's a shutoff over there, so they thought about that, I guess. Maybe that was just a code thing, but all the rest of that is no good.
Mini splits are a really simple solution to a complicated problem. HVAC zoning is difficult. Just because something's simple does not mean it's easy though. When you're installing these, or your HVAC installer or your contractor's installing one of these, there's a ton of considerations to be made. So we hope that this video can help you identify some key problems, something that someone might mess up, or you know, just make it sound like you know what you're talking about when you're asking your installer, why'd you put it here and why not high up on the wall? Where's the insulation around my line set? Where does the condensate go? Why aren't these lines wrapped? So the more knowledge, the more likely you are to have a better install, and we hope this helps. And we hope no one ever has a mini split installed as poorly as this one right here. Mini splits are supposed to be something that are straightforward and solving a problem that, So mini sim, our goal is to show you, So we hope that you're able to, let me take it over again. What's uncommon is the frequency on such a small install. So this should have been an easy install, but just because it's, he's having a breakdown.
all right.
He's melting on camera.
Right. He's too hot. Dude, I'm in my head now. I think I'm too relaxed.
Yeah.
I'm too relaxed. I need to say, and we've had lunch. I'm not even hungry anymore. Mini splits are really, really, why am I saying really twice? Like a
really, really ridiculously easy.
Mini splits.